This crash site's a nightmare. Edie, try to raise Lieutenant Victus.
Yes, sir.
Praetorian Commander, what happened here is... Let's just say the Turian code is not forgiving. And that it's his son is bad for the Primarch. Promoting family without merit can bite you in the ass. What's strange is the Primarch knows that.
Commander, I have to land well back from the main crash site.
That the best you can do?
Yes, sir. But the Reapers seem unaware of our presence. You might get the jump on them.
All right, set her down. Let's save this platoon. Edie, did you raise Lieutenant Victus?
Yes, but the connection is bad.
Patch me in. This is Commander Shepard, Alliance Navy. Do you read?
This is Lieutenant Tarquin Victus of the 9th Platoon. We're pinned by Reaper harvesters and taking heavy casualties. Also, there are pockets of my men scattered along the crash trajectory.
Lieutenant, I need you to fire a flare so I can find your position. Got it.
Things get worse by the minute. My men are dying.
This sounds bad. Let's move.
Looks worse than I feared.
You got it.
Turian mission on Tuchanka is especially odd. Thoughts?
Nothing has come up through any of my networks.
Shh, you see them?
Quick, we don't want them to call for backup.
Escape pod. Our first casualties.
Looks like they survived the crash, but then a harvester took them out.
Died in the explosion?
And then pulled out to be eaten by husks. Shepard, I hear gunfire.
Okay. I have a visual on the enemy. And there's an escape pod just beyond. Looks like the Turians are in tough. Enemies up ahead don't know we're here.
Surprise on our side for once. I like it.
Exactly. Let's go.
Save them all. Excellent work.
Keep moving. We need to find the main crash site ASAP.
Being the son of Adrian Victus is a lot to live up to. It's a big military name on Palavin. War's expected to run in the Victus blood.
Children shouldn't be burdened with the successes of their parents any more than their failings.
Looks like we've got the job. Follow my lead.
I think we saved all those men.
This way.
Over here.
Shepard here. What's your status?
We're in deep. Commander, what's your ETA?
Hang tight. We're on our way.
Arnik, how's our velocity?
Deceleration online. We'll survive.
Victus is going to pay for this.
Court-martial or hanging?
How's Victus going to live this down?
When we find him, we'll ask. Shepard here.
Just saw harvesters drop a lot of enemies in your path.
Understood.
Okay. Let's pick it up. It's important we don't lose this squad.
It seems that the Turians are playing with political dynamite here. Maybe they should inform the Krogan.
Krogan-Turian animosity is ancient and intense. It's inborn.
And I need them to work together, so let's not complicate things.
Let's move!
Not one more soldier dies here today!
For Kalavan!
Thank you.
This way.
Lieutenant Victus?
Commander Shepard, my men and I are in your debt. Thank you for saving so many.
What happened here?
He screwed up.
Stand down, soldier.
These men are dead because of him.
I said, stand down.
Hey, I just saved all your asses, so everyone just calm down. Lieutenant, what's going on here?
I made a bad call. This is all on me. I chose caution and clever tactics over a head-on attack. And my men paid the price.
You mean the crash?
Yes. We could see on Hollow that Reaper forces were blocking our intended path. Staying on course guaranteed heavy casualties. So I chose a safer route, skirting the enemy. And that took us low and through these ruins. When we encountered resistance, there was no room to maneuver. Suddenly, we were in a fight for our lives. A lot of my men lost that fight.
Owning your mistake takes guts. But you have to get over it and move on.
Of course. It's just fresh right now. Our mission's still a failure. When we've stabilized the injured, we'll head back to the fleet.
You're abandoning your mission?
We're down over 30 men. It'd be suicide.
What exactly did you come here to do?
There's a bomb on the planet. We were sent to defuse it.
A bomb? How big?
Enormous. Cerberus has it.
Lieutenant, if Cerberus has that bomb, you have to finish your mission.
Haven't these men sacrificed enough?
I understand. This kind of sacrifice is the hardest to ask for, but your men signed on for it. And so did you.
My men have lost hope, Commander. Even if I wanted to finish the mission, they don't.
It's your job to make them want to.
How?
Their sacrifice means that others will never face what they faced here today. Remind them that those sacrifices have no honor if the mission fails.
Men, I own what happened here today. But we have to carry on.
No, we don't. Who cares about a few dead Krogan? It's over.
We are Turian. And we will not let Cerberus succeed. Our sacrifice is the difference between life and death for this entire galaxy. Let the heroes of the 9th Platoon be remembered for performing their duties with bravery. All right, men. Shuttle's arriving any minute. We're moving out. Commander, come with us. We're a shell of what we were. We could use the help.
Send me the nav point. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you. That'll give us time to do a little recon. See what we're up against.
Victus, you have a second chance here. Make their sacrifice count.
Understood, Commander. Hope to see you at the rendezvous.
Cerberus bomb. What the hell is going on, Commander? And what do the Turians have to do with it?
Coordinates Victus gave me place it in the Kelphic Valley. It's a heavily populated area. That's all I know.
My gut says something's not right here.
What do you suggest?
Get the Primarch to come clean.
Should we alert the Krogan military?
I'd wait. We're in the dark here. Krogan-Turian relations are fragile until the genophage is cured. Let's not push it. And how about this bomb? How many troops does Cerberus have on this?
No idea. All I know is we can't have them detonating that bomb.
Keep me in the loop. Hack it out.
Primarch Victus.
Impressive work on Tuchanka. I'm grateful that...
Why didn't you tell me about the Cerberus bomb? Why hide that? What else are you keeping from me?
I have nothing for you.
For our alliance to work, I need to trust you.
Our friendship is new, Commander. Would you trust me with information that puts your people, puts Earth, at risk?
Why would I jeopardize our alliance by lying to you now? Doesn't make sense.
Decisions like these weigh heavy on me. When I was a general, I could pass them up the chain of command. But now, I'm all I've got. Know what I mean?
Sure. And?
And that's all. Wait, there is one more thing, Commander. Thank you for saving my son.
Commander, Admiral Anderson is available on VidCom.
Shepard, so I imagine by now you've wiped the galaxy clean of Reapers and we can all come up for air?
Not quite. There have been a few complications.
Aren't there always? Hackett filled me in on the Crucible. Sounds like you've got some knots to untangle.
I'm just glad I could take care of one of them for you. I gather you and Kaylee Sanders were close.
I owe you for that one, Shepard. Kaylee and I met almost 20 years ago. We even had a run-in with Saren in his early days. She and I were... more than close.
She misses you.
I miss her. End of the world has a way of reminding you what you forgot to do. Maybe when the war's over, Kaylee and I will do something about that.
You'll see her soon.
I can hope. But you've got a bigger problem right now. Like a galaxy full of scared bureaucrats.
It's what you hired me to do.
Mostly you were hired to kill Reapers. I hope you haven't been sidetracked by all the politics.
Nothing I can't handle. What about you? What's happening on Earth?
I'll spare you the details. But let's just say a lot of cities around the world have stopped checking in.
That bad?
You and I knew what we were in for, but everyone else? I don't think the shock's worn off yet.
Are you safe?
That changes by the hour. I caught a shuttle evac out of Vancouver, and now we're running from foxhole to foxhole just trying to stay alive.
What about the Reapers?
They're harvesting everything that moves. They're focusing on the big cities, which does give us some room to maneuver.
You think you can hang on?
Hell, we're still just trying to talk to each other. Right now, all we can do is organize the resistance at a local level. No lack of volunteers, at least. Everybody knows what's at stake.
I don't know how we'll win this yet, but we will. Even if it kills me.
Well, you've already died once, and that didn't slow you down. But let's not tempt fate. Keep yourself safe, Shepard.
You too, sir.
We'll talk again soon. Anderson out.
I'm grateful for all you've done, Commander. The situation with the Krogan is already complicated enough.
Not as complicated as waking up one day and being told you're the new Primarch.
Yes, thank you. I'm beginning to understand why leaders so often seem lonely. Worst-case scenarios aren't just theories. They're what you'll be dealing with 5 minutes from now.
That's why it helps to have allies.
Yes, you're right, of course. Is there something I can help you with?
That's all.
Of course, Commander.
What was that all about with the Primarch? Turian's up to something?
It's nothing. Don't worry about it.
Uh-huh. All right.
That's it for now, Rex. Let's get back to work.
Yeah.
Something wrong?
Morden. He got his tissue sample from me, all right. Let's just say scalpels were never meant to cut where he cut.
So, Reapers don't have colonies. You can't bomb them, or you're bombing what's left of your own planet. They make their own soldiers out of our civilians. They don't have supply lines. How do you beat something like that?
I'll let you know if I think of something.
Commander, Cerberus is attacking civilians on Benning. We've been asked to help evacuate the planet. Look at that galaxy map. Do you know how many strategy games are built from that interface?
You play strategy games?
A few. Most are too flashy, though. I prefer chess. I have a set made from rose quartz and hematite back home. I like the feel of something solid in my hands.
Sounds like it's more than just a hobby.
After last year's tournament, I was 20-85 on the Grissom scale. Not an international level, but respectable. I would have placed higher if I hadn't lost my knights. Every game I overextended them, got too flashy, and then watched them fall.
Well, Now that I know your weakness, we may have to try a game.
Are you all right, Commander? It sounded like things were bad down there.
The Turians took some heavy losses, but we got them out okay.
Well, whatever you did down there stirred up a lot of Turian comm traffic.
What are they saying?
Sorry, it's encrypted. Cracking it would take at least a week, and it would be wrong.
The Turians will hold. Pound for pound, they're the best fighting force in the galaxy.
Pound for pound is irrelevant, given the significantly higher mass of Reaper forces overall.
That's why we're bringing in the Krogan. So that went well. Glad to see that Turians can flip out and lose their shit just like the rest of us.
They're under a lot of pressure.
You stole the Normandy, got blown up by the Collectors, and sent us on a suicide mission to the Galactic Core. And I haven't mutinied once. Not once.
I am impressed by your continued existence, Shepard. The probability of surviving as long as you have is low.
Commander, Chief Engineer Adams would like to speak with you down in engineering.
Enough about me. What were you doing before we met up here?
Oh, you know, this and that.
Come on, spill it to Sony.
Very well. I fought several explosive battles with Cerberus. I helped Shepard stop a robotic assassin on Mars. Oh, and I discovered plans for a Prothean doomsday device that were buried for 50,000 years.
Yeah, so just this and that, huh?
Hello, Shepard.
Turians on a secret mission to Tuchanka, huh? No one told me anything about it. I'm curious to see how this bomb on Tuchanka plays out. I don't suppose ignoring it is an option.
Doctor, I'd like to hear the song.
Again? Trying to calculate amino acid decay rates.
You said you would once the tests were done.
Oh, better to die to a thresh, a maw with shotgun blasting, roaring raw, than to play ambassadorial games with the blood of Chiager in her veins. Off to fight since Turians can't, with diplomats instead of a crant, but she'll be true to Tuchanka's dream, and live and die a Krogan queen. For she is the Krogan queen, hurrah, hurrah for the Krogan queen, and it is a glorious thing to be the Krogan queen. Still prefer patter songs.
Of course. I really had to twist your arm.
Not sure what to think about that little mech dog roaming the ship.
You mean Sophie? I think she's cute.
What purpose does she serve?
I guess I have a soft spot for worthless dogs. Look how long I've been with you.
You should go see Adams, Commander.
Adams would like to speak to you.
Commander, remember the problem I mentioned? About a core overload possibly venting into the engineering compartment? Daniels, Donnelly, Edie, and I have been brainstorming and comparing notes.
You see, the venting occurs when IES sinks are in a back cycle, at the same moment the main core is at peak draw, such as from sustained kinetic.
What Kenneth means to say is that we're pretty sure we can make the system safer.
We just need a GX-12 thermal pipe. Unfortunately, we're cut off from Alliance supply chains. Could you keep an eye out for one the next time you're on the Citadel, Commander? I've got the specs right here.
Are these modifications really necessary?
It's a safety issue, not exactly critical. Under extreme conditions, like heavy bombardment to the kinetic barriers while traveling at peak flight speeds, plasma can vent into this compartment.
It would vaporize anyone standing in this room.
That sounds more serious than just a safety issue.
Well, under those conditions, odds are you're about to lose the entire ship anyway.
But we want every advantage we can get, right?
I'll look for one next time we go to the Citadel.
Thanks, Commander.
I heard about the events on Tuchanka. You should not have let the Turian soldier evade his responsibility.
I take it Protheans didn't forgive many mistakes?
If he had been under my command, I would have marooned him in the desert, buried him in sand up to his neck, and let the wildlife feast on his eyes. If he survived that, I would have rewarded him by shooting him in the head. Good soldiers are a precious resource. The stupidity of one cannot be allowed to jeopardize the lives of the others. The Turians are hiding something, Commander. Be careful. Tuchanka was not always a wasteland. It once had jungles and forests. Krogan didn't need the Reapers to destroy their world. They did it on their own. Such a foolish race.
Dire news from Earth. Off the radar, reaping begins in rural areas. Millions are dead in the Central Asian wilderness, even more in sub-Saharan Africa. We'll give you the gruesome view of what happens when the Reapers don't stop to indoctrinate. Now, in the battle space.
Hey, Esteban, for your shuttle being so stealthy and all, you sure do get shot at a lot.
Well, the UT-47A stealth systems only internalize heat and high-band emissions. So while few sensors can pick us up, our cover is blown as soon as someone looks up.
Time for an upgrade.
Most scanners and tracking systems don't operate in mid-range frequencies. Sure, maybe we've been shot at, but we haven't been shot down.
Yet. Lucky for us, you're almost as good a pilot as you think you are.
Well, yeah. There's that, too. Doesn't hurt to go over the weapon roster one more time. Good to see you, Commander.
Primarch's son is in over his head, no?
Right now.
So, how did I get volunteered to crawl through the ducts?
You're the power control engineer, not me.
Damn hot in here. Hey, didn't Adam say that all the Normandy is Edie?
Kenneth, stop right there.
Just didn't tell Joker. He'll get jealous.
Kenneth is still installing the thermal conduit down in the crawl space. We'll have a report later.
Cerberus strike squads have infiltrated one of the major cities on Benning. Initial reports indicated they were recruiting civilians, but further investigations suggest that the people are being taken against their will.
For what purpose?
Unknown. We sent a recon team to investigate, and the Cerberus squads reacted by targeting civilians in public facilities. Officially, Cerberus is denying responsibility and condemning the action. They're either lying, or we're dealing with a rogue faction.
And innocents are caught in their crosshairs.
Exactly. Secure the area so we can establish a rescue lifeline to the rest of the city.
Approaching the drop point, Commander.
Copy that, Lieutenant.
The people down there are counting on you, Commander. Hack it out.
Fielding an avalanche of civilian SOS requests, Commander. The bulk are concentrated on the upper street. Cerberus forces are pinning them down. You better hurry.
On my way. Keep me updated.
Roger that.
Thank you.
What is it, Lieutenant?
I'm tracking civilians fleeing the city with Cerberus troops right behind.
Where are they?
Updating your nav point. You can intercept them there.
They won't know what hit them.
Try to stay calm.
What? What should we do?
Just stay down.
Commander, more Cerberus troops are heading your way. If you can hold the line there, it'll give the civilians time to escape.
You heard him. We hold here.
Not letting you out of my sight.
You're clear! Go!
No hostiles detected in the immediate area, Commander. Reinforcements are moving in to secure the evac route.
Good work, everyone.
I'll pick you up at the LZ, Commander.
We're getting reports of continuing strikes against other cities on Benning.
Cerberus still denying responsibility?
Yes, and for once we're inclined to believe them. Gunning down innocent humans isn't their usual MO. Either way, the civilians down there have a chance now. We're solidifying a foothold and getting people out, then we'll move to liberating the rest of the planet.
I hope we can say the same for Earth.
One day, Commander. For now, we've got our work cut out for us. Carry on.
We could be on the front lines. Why have they got us guarding a door anyway? He's gonna break regs right now.
War makes people stupid. Besides, you talked with Moreau? Electors invaded this ship and kidnapped the crew.
Damn. Okay, I guess we gotta be ready for anything to come through that door.
Maximum dynamic pressure is approaching. Throttle down for minimal resistance.
Thanks, Mom.
If that is how you categorize me, I will tell you to stop slouching.
Certainly possible. Would require strengthening exercises. Get muscles to support weaker bone structure.
All right. Yeah, I can do that.
Alloy of Edie's body not flexible like organic tissue could cause unintentional damage. Recommend pillows, cushions, possibly gel packs.
Okay, that's a little weirder, but yeah, all right, cushions.
Positioning critical to success. Can forward Edie charts, videos with relevant data.
No, Edie's pretty busy with, you know, stuff. Let's send that to me. You're not gonna tell anyone about this, right? Like Shepard? Shepard doesn't really need to know.
Guarantee Shepard won't learn about it from me.
He's standing right there, isn't he?
I wish I wasn't.
Dr. Tassoni found useful information in the data you recovered, Commander.
Working on anything?
I'm helping decode some of the Crucible's designs, or trying to. Theoretical particle physics based on specialized base 12 mathematics aren't exactly my specialty. And Javik is his usual forthcoming self. I'd trade my last 100 years to resurrect even one Prothean scientist to help us. I've never seen Krogan move with such purpose. It's a little terrifying.
How do you see with only two eyes? Evolution has taken a strange turn in this cycle. Your Joker pilot insists I call myself Prothe the Prothean. I insisted he allow me to throw him out the airlock. Commander.
Can't believe Cerberus would open fire on civilians like that. As twisted and insane as his logic might be, I thought the elusive man was trying to save humanity. I guess he's willing to sacrifice anyone to win.
Yes, his squad did return.
Have you found my son?
I found your son's body in the slums on Benny. He sacrificed himself to save his squad.
I see. Their guilt made them avoid me. They should feel honored by his sacrifice. I know that I do. Thank you, my friend.
Installation of that thermal pipe you got us.
It went right brilliant. Much better than we expected.
I told you it would.
It gets better. While interfacing through our Ezo capacitors, our Miss Daniels here had an epiphany.
I wouldn't go that far.
She and Donnelly deduced some theoretical improvements to our capacitor design. Edie and I ran with it and documented our conclusions. Our core is too compact to apply our theories, but it could help the Crucible engineers. Give the word and they'll send the plans their way.
Do it. Well done, everyone.